What does it mean to me to be a courageous leader? So it means a lot. It's something I'm committed to. And how do I take what I learned there and apply it? Well, really, first I need to recognize that I have the power to focus my thoughts wherever I want them. And even though we're born with certain thoughts about fear and things that we're unsure of, you know, it doesn't mean that I can't retrain the way that I look at fear and the way that I go ahead in life. I don't have to rely on that. I must realize that fear and being uncomfortable is a good thing. And I've trained myself to engage difficult situations. When I know that I want to run from one, I go head first at it. It doesn't mean that it's easy, you know. Since we all have fears, and most courageous leaders have admitted they have fears, you know, I believe that you have to be strong enough in your convictions to know that it's okay to show that. It's okay to say, I'm afraid of this. It's okay to show that you have weaknesses, and sometimes that'll be viewed as unattractive, and that's okay. When I'm vulnerable like that, it gives my staff the permission to be vulnerable also. They take more risks. They know that it's okay to fail. And I don't want to make it sound that simple, because it takes courage to be authentic. It takes courage to look at people and know that some of the decisions you make are considered bold or risky or may not be popular. And that's okay. But I don't hide it, and I encourage the people that I work with to embrace that. And it's where I see our greatest growth and our ability to change. I apply it to change because I know, hey, at least we tried. And we laugh at it, and my staff laugh at it all the time when I make mistakes, and they see my failures, and I think that's a good thing. I think that helps me continue to grow as a courageous leader. So I don't stop if I fail. I encourage other people not to. I look for the next opportunity to promote change. I find other solutions that may not have worked the first time. Sometimes you have to revisit it more than once. And I tell everybody, when I wrote this, I started thinking about, like, I tell everybody I have very thick skin. Everything rolls off of me. And what I really thought about was, I don't have any thicker skin than anybody else in this room. But what I do is I have made a choice to have it. And all of you have too. Because when you work with the public in retail in a changing environment, you make a choice to do that. You have to have thick skin, right? I do it because I want to be a courageous leader for the people that I'm here to serve. And that's not just the people that work in the store alongside of me and that allow me to be there, but really for everyone in our community. So it's part of that also. And I know that in the retail climate that we're in, and one that's continuing from everything we just heard to change and grow, I'm glad to know that I'm gonna have to grow even more in my courageous leadership, because it's exciting to me. I really want to continue to grow in this so that I can assure that I do my part for the co-op that I'm with, or my community, so we can continue to develop and grow into greatness. Not just mediocrity, not just the co-op, you know, the one co-op in this town, but that people, when they know about us, they know we do good work, that we really, really do what we say we do. So I think that's what courageous leadership looks like to me. Thanks. Appreciate it.